Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to create a talent for your iClone. So the first, what you need to do is open your iClone, create, surface, plane. The next, open your pen. So here, click resize, select pixel. So make sure untick this, maintain aspect ratio, untick. Here you type in 2048, here also 2048. Then click OK. So this is the texture, you just need to paint it. As demo, I just to fill in with green color. Then I save on my desktop, file, save as. Here I choose PNG and save on my desktop. This is texture 2048 green. Okay, now I already save it as a picture. You should be able to see the extension of the file. If you cannot see the extension, just go to the Explorer. Then you click View. Select here, View. And make sure you untick this. High extension for known file type, please untick it and click apply. After that, you should be able to see the file extension. This is very important for us to create all this. So now I close the Explorer. The texture already created. So now I can close this. The next, back to your iClone, double click the plane and select this, click here. This is the base color. This is the original texture. We replace it. Drag your texture to here. Then it will become a green color. Here you still can adjust the color. Just to right click, adjust color, change the hue. Here you can change the color. All right. So now, the next step, click here. Edit in 3D Exchange. So in this stage, you need to export it out as FBX. So now I open a new folder. Square plane, green. I'm going to export the FBX here. Click FBX. Click the location, copy. Control A to select all. Paste here. Rename it. Square, plane, green. Okay, now this is the FBX file. Open your Blender. If you don't have Blender, this is a free software you can download from this website, blender.org/download/. Then you download the latest version of the Blender. After that, open your Blender. First, delete these three objects. Select it, delete. After that, you want to import the FBX here. File, import FBX, copy from here, copy the location, Control C to copy, paste it here, Control V, enter. The next, double click the square plane green. So now you already import this square plane into your Blender. So the first thing you need to do, you can click this to show the texture. Then next step, click on the mesh. You will see the orange color boulder, means you already select it. Come to here, edit mode. So this is a low poly, we need to right click, subdivide, right click, subdivide, right click and subdivide a few times until it becomes a lot of faces. If you feel that it's too much, you also can control Z to reduce it. The next step, just go to sculpting. So same as here, if you click this, you show the texture, but I prefer to click this so that I can view it clearer. So if I want to add the mountain, I just use this tool. So you see, it is symmetry. So I don't want this, just to control Z to undo. It is symmetry, so to remove the symmetry, you have to come here, symmetry. Here, X is selected. We need to click on X so that deselect it. Now, it will just left. Okay, if you want to undo, it's Control Z. So now I can adjust the mountain. I want to create some mountain. The radius, I can make it bigger. Create a mountain here, or if don't want, I can make the mountain smaller. Okay, so now I already create a mountain at here. So middle click your mouse, then you can rotate the camera. So here I want to make it higher. Okay, you can create some more mountain. You also can create reverse. If you want to create reverse, you select this. So I can just shoot at here. Hold my mouse. Okay, I want to make this river bigger. The radius should be bigger. No, not this. The strength, make it more serious. Okay, now I can create a better river. So later on, you can fill some water right here. So the next, you can just view. So this is a texture view. Next, maybe you feel that you want to paint on it. Here, maybe you want to put another leg. I want to add one more leg at here. I want to make a small leg here. Later, I can fill some water. Alright, so next, view. And you go to the texture pane. At the texture pane here, you can put some color. If you want to move the camera, you can click on this and hold your mouse. Then you can move it. Oh, where is it? Where is it? Totally missing. Okay, somewhere here. Okay, Control Z, I don't want this. Alright, here then I choose a color. Let's say I want to paint on this. I choose a color. Okay, if I want to paint, I can change the radius to make it smaller. Then I can paint some snow at here. You can make it better than me. This is as a demo, I just simply paint it. So you must do better than me. And this is a river, then I can paint some of the sands beside the river. Change the color. Then maybe I can make it bigger. This is a radius, I can change it. Okay, so now I can paint some of the sands here. Okay, here. Okay. After you feel satisfied with your parents, then you can export it out. Just back to the layout and select everything. File. Export as FBX. So choose your original folder here. Okay, copy this location. Copy is Control C. Back to your Blender. Here should be File, Export, FBX. Paste your location here, enter. So now we don't want to replace this. We put rename it as done. So export. So now you have this. This is the wrong name, should be done. Done. So back to your 3D exchange. This one you want to import into your icon. Okay. So in your Blender, go to the UV editing. And you export it out this. Just to click select on the image, save as, then you choose the desktop. Okay, this one you can name it as, okay, you don't want to rename it also, okay, save as image. Then the image is here, you exported out the PNG already, you just to drag in. Then now it is already done here. Okay, so this is as a demo, I just simply paint it. If you really want to create it a beautiful terrain, you must do better than me. So this one I can apply to iClone. Make sure the iClone you clear the template, new project. Don't want to save this. And the next, just to import this, apply to iClone. Apply to iClone. The iClone is ready. So again, this one, select, tick use RGB. The color will be better. Then I need to fill with some water, just to click this. Then right click the water, find file. That should be better. So now I view the water. Can drag out some water from here. Water with gentler width. So now I can adjust. I can adjust the height of the color. Sorry, adjust the height of the water. This is a height variable. Use my mouse to scroll on it. Okay, then what is the water color? The water should be this color. Okay. So now as you see, you can see your lake. And you can see the river. At the same time, you can see your shore. And this is the mountain, and you already paint the snow on it. So at this time, you are going to save this as a prop. Double click it. Click here, custom, prop. If you save it as a prop, click plus. Then this prop, you can use it anytime after you delete it. You still can use it anytime because it is a prop. So this water should be higher. So you also can adjust this. Control G to stop the grid. So now if I click play, if you did do your animation, you can play it. And next, you can right click to convert to Terran also. Okay, you can double click your Terran, then right click, convert to Terran. Then once you already convert to Terran, so just to click here, custom, Terran, then you click plus. Now you also add a new Terran. So if I start a new template, this one can use as a Terran. Okay, drag. So this one already become a Terran. Just now that one is a prop. I save both. So this is a prop that you can use it anytime.
Go to the bottom of the video and click subscribe. Click the bell to receive all the notifications for every time I publish a new video and tutorial if you love it. If you find it helpful, I will keep on posting more and more tutorials for you.
Oh.